Amongst the church fathers who believed in the triune God like the way you do.
There was a kid, okay, a document written in the 1990s.
I didn't ask him what the document, I asked him what the church fathers. I asked his church father.
I don't care what stipulation.
Now he doesn't care.
Because I was a still Christian.
This is where these films production is coming.
Okay.
I'm not coming in.
So in terms of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, do you believe that the Son was begetted by the Father?
I believe the Son was begetted.
Did the Father beget the Son?
What do you mean? You took about doctrine at the turn of generation.
Beget, you know what beget means?
Yes, I know what beget. So what's the
Bible? Did he beget the Son or not?
Well, let me finish. The Bible says he only begot the Son of God.
Okay, so he did beget the Son, right?
I did.
Okay. His begetting means there is contingency here. Now that you're dependent on the Father to be begotten. Even if it's from eternity. It is not a saint. Do you agree?
No, again, you're getting out of it. Saint is not. Oh, so this is also next. What I'm saying is that the Son, what the Father holds, not the Son.
Sorry, guys.
I'm talking to you.
Because the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit are autophagous. Right?
You know what a saint means?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
What does it mean?
Let me explain what I'm saying. Because the Son, the Father, and the Spirit are autophagous. Right? The way the Father perceives the Son is that he's turning into generated. So what happens is every time any instance the Father is in possession, he's always perceiving the Son.
Do you know what a saint means? What does a saint mean? Explain that.
Oh, I have to get a text for this
one. So I don't know what it is. I'll tell you what a saint means if you don't know. Okay?
I've heard of it.
But you don't know what it is, so let me explain to you what it is.
I'll drop my mind.
So a saint basically means someone who is independent. Someone.
Right. So subordination.
No. Someone who is independent. Someone who is not dependent on anyone for their existence. Okay?
Your God has a problem with that.
Well, before you come to my God, let's deal with yours.
The most merciful.
Because you admit it, that the Father generates eternally the Son and the Holy Spirit. Am I right?
Since from the Father, he's also fails.
Or do you believe, I don't know, are you Eastern Orthodox or you're...
I believe in the monarchism of the Father. The Eastern Orthodox believe that as well, whereas the Father...
Yeah, but...
The Son proceeds from the Father.
Yes. For the Eastern Orthodox, the Son and the Holy Spirit...
No, they don't believe in the Holy Spirit. They believe the one Catholic.
The Son proceeds from the Father. The Son is worshipped and glorified.
And the ones who are not Eastern Orthodox, the Catholics and the
Roman
Catholics,
they believe...
I think you're wrong. I think it's the other way around. Because the Catholics, they believe that the Son proceeds from the Father, and the Son spirates the Holy Spirit. But for the Eastern Orthodox, the Father and the Son, the Son and the Holy Spirit.
The Father generates the Son, and the Son spirates the Spirit. Right?
Yeah. Make sure that it's on, yeah?
And the Roman Catholics believe that both the Father and the Son generate the Spirit.
Okay. Either way, there's a difference in the Western and the Eastern Orthodox, because one believes...
Yes.
Let's forget about the fact. One believes that both the Son and the Holy Spirit generate from the Father, okay, or spirate from the Father, whereas the other believes that
only the Son,
proceeds from the Father, and the Holy Spirit spirates from the Son.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a difference, and that's why there's schism dividing the Western and the Eastern. Okay, so in terms of aseity, both of them believe that it's the Father who's the source, yes, when it comes to the generation and the spiration.
Yeah.
Okay? So we know that the Son and the Holy Spirit cannot exist without the Father.
Yeah.
But the Father can exist independently, hence he's said to be a saint. Okay? That means he's independent.
Yeah, you're assuming. You're assuming one thing. What we believe is that God by nature always precedes the Son and always generates the Spirit. That's how he is.
So are you saying it is necessary for God to have a Son?
God by nature always has a Son.
Is it necessary or is it something which he can choose not to have?
No, it's a necessary part of his nature.
So is it necessary for him to have a Son?
Yeah.
Without the Son, he cannot be God.
He always generates a Son. That's his nature.
Always exists.
Can he be a Son? Can he be a God without generating a Son?
It was always God.
The question was always God. I'm asking about dependency, independence. I can't
tell you anything other than the Bible. What I'm saying is the Bible is autotheos, the Son is autotheos, and the Spirit is autotheos.
It means they're all God, right?
Yes,
so Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Spirit is God.
What I'm saying is that...
How many gods?
We've done this before.
So
you said it was three gods.
You said the Father is God, the Son is God, the Holy Spirit is God. Right. What do people think other than the Christians on this?
Yeah, because they're stupid.
What does people think?
Are you putting everyone stupid?
I'm saying that people who assume stupid things. Assuming stupid things doesn't make you stupid.
But how can you say they're assuming stupid things? When
they
people
haven't looked into the doctrine properly, they assume stupid.
No, the doctrine is extra biblical. That's the reason it took them 400 years to establish it.
No, not necessarily. As I just stated, there are problems.
When was the doctrine of the Trinity?
Let's be sensible now.